Hello everyone and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube. Welcome to my NCAA 13 Online Dynasty on the Xbox. This is the one that I am starting off with my fans, my viewers, and some other YouTubers, mostly viewers though, and people who have been around my channel for quite a bit. So I'm going with the Pitt Panthers here. We made this a 3-star and lower online dynasty here in NCAA 13. So I'm going to take the Pitt Panthers and my buddy Junk Gaming Videos. Yes, he's in this year. He's got the Xbox. He's got the copy of NCAA. We didn't get to play against each other last year. So I'm looking forward to this. He's going to jump in as UCLA. So we might not play head to head. But we are in the same dynasty and we get to live out the same seasons and whatnot. So that's kind of cool. I've been looking forward to playing in a league with him for a while now. So now that's actually happening. Also, some of my other buddies, Insane Predator's back. He's always good to play his games. Caveman Swag was on there. We have others. So looking at my roster pretty quick, I've got a really beast halfback in Ray Graham. These are real rosters, so we got that going for us. Doing some redshirting of players who I don't think are going to see the field this year anyway. And looking at the Dynasty Wire for the first time. So also going to check out the Heisman Watch. Like I said, real names. So Matt Barkley leads up that list with Monty Ball, Tyrone Mathieu, Denard Robinson, and Landry Jones rounding off the Heisman Watch there. So you got five really quality stars who probably will duke it out for that Heisman this year. A little bit of recruiting. The new recruit board. Love it this year. You've actually got some scouting going on, which makes things a lot better. No longer are you just a 2-star, 3-star, 4-star, 5-star recruit, but you've got actual attributes that can be unlocked by scouting a prospect, like I'm doing right here with Curtis Harrell. You'll see he's up a little bit better than expected in some areas. And therefore, he's rated a 65, and he's like a plus one there. So this guy here, a plus three. But you want to scout them 100% before you'll know exactly what you're getting. So you only get, I believe, 3 hours of scouting a week. You got to use it wisely. Try to open up some of these deals and find out who your gems are and who your busts are. And this one right here, now we're going to get into the actual pitches. You know, that's like it is in previous years, but tweaked a little bit. So really, after doing a few dynasties online, now you're going to see dynasties all over the place, folks, because I'm in two on both consoles.
At the confluence of the three rivers, Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. In Pittsburgh, you have to play tough. You have to be ready to be rugged. Hard-nosed running football, and that's what we expect to have in our game today. That's going to wrap it up here in the studio, but we'll be here to keep you up to date on everything else going on in college football throughout our game. But it's time for ESPN's College Football. Brett Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit on the call. Herbstreit
here in the booth. All right, love those new intros to the games this year. So this is week one. We're going to jump right into, in the Online Dynasty, my game is my Pitt Panthers against an FCS foe here. So this is a very much a tune-up game, and we'll try to get things going in the right track against a lesser opponent. So we're going to hand off to Ray Graham, our beast of a halfback here, expecting big things from him this year. He gets a first down, and we get our first studio update, which is Texas A&M just barely beating Louisiana Tech. So the studio updates, the ESPN ticker added to Dynasty this year, add a great dimension to what you're playing here. That pass is over the middle, and we've got a catch, but we also have an injury here. That's not what we want to see, a tight end going down right away. You got Hubie Graham on the deck here. He's a senior, and hopefully he's all right. He's pointing to his arm. Hopefully it's not going to keep him out for extended periods of time. You see Sunseri back in the pocket, but he's throwing over the middle, and it's picked off. Oh, well, we got some rust to shake off early in the season here, namely so from the quarterback position right now. Sunseri is a good quarterback. He's hitting Street, and oh, more rust. Street fumbles this ball here after getting the first down. There is a nice hustle play by your quarterback to save a touchdown return on the play. But boy, oh boy, can we cut down on the turnovers here? This is killing me. First, a bad read by the quarterback, me, controlling him, obviously. But here is something a little bit out of my control. A fumble that would have been a first down play, but instead it goes the other way here, and it's putting added pressure on the defense. By the way, did I mention, I'm a defensive coordinator only. I went with a real coach this time. I didn't name him. So, offensive coordinator only to start this out, which is why you're not seeing the defense. Hand off to Ray Graham, and that's nice yardage. It's second and two now. What can we do on second and two? Play action. Pass to Holtz. Nice play, makes a man miss, and gets to midfield before being tackled. You see the replay here. He slid a little bit. You see that more and more in the replays this year, and not really a fan of that, but whatever, take the good with the bad. Not sure why we regressed on replays when they were so damn good last year. We've got a problem with Street. You saw he got rocked there in that fumble. He gets turf toe and is going to be out two quarters here. The game freezes a little bit, but Sinceri throws off to the right-hand side. Oh, just short. It's fourth and one. They got a punt. Wow, just kind of a wash in the first quarter there. Too many turnovers and just nothing really clicking. And, well, the second quarter is going to start the same way, forcing this pass that Parker will pick off. Oh, boy. Coaching staff is like, what is going on, man? You're better than this. Let's do this. So they're backed up to their inch line. I mean, this is like 99.5 yards. And Graham is going to get out to the right side. Oh, boy. He's going to take it the distance. He's got afterburners, folks, and no one's going to catch him. He blazes down the field for the touchdown, and they're going to rule this a 100-yard scamper. That's right. You can't get any farther from a play from scrimmage anyway, unless you're returning a kick in the back of the end zone. That's a 100-yard touchdown rush, and it gets Pittsburgh on the right track. This is obviously what they're looking for, and this is one of their stars performing. Ray Graham taking that handoff, and he shows his speed going all the way to the end zone for the touchdown. So 7-0 Pitt now. Still second quarter. Going to hand off to Graham again to the right-hand side. Nice yardage, about 9, 9.5. So second and one. Sinceri under center, and he's going to throw to Shanahan. And he says, get off me! You're not going to tackle me with that play. He's down the sideline as well. Broken tackle leads to touchdown. Another long play for Pittsburgh's offense. 14-0. That's more like it. That's what we expected out of the gate. It took a quarter plus of play to get there, but they've shaken off the cobwebs now and are beating a lesser opponent, as they should. So 14-0 now after he scampers to the house, and the fans are loving this at Heinz Field. Oh yeah, body paint, all that good stuff. And we've got a 14-0 game still with about 1:10 before half. Going to pass to Shanahan, and again, he's not going to break the tackle this time, but he does get a first down. First and 10 now. That pass, oh my goodness, what a catch. He lays out to make the catch. And we've got Syracuse in a dogfight with Northwestern there. Ah, wow, I don't know if they're going to survive that or not. We'll have to see. That's the fun of this. You can kind of look back, and he throws his third pick of the game. My goodness, can he chase him down? Well, he saved a touchdown before, and he is going to be able to do the same again. But he's thrown three picks in this first half. Come on! Yes, I know, for those of you who don't like my style of treating this as a real game, I know I threw those picks. Thank you for pointing it out. I'm getting into the gameplay as if this were a real dynasty, okay? So I'm laying it right on Sinceri's shoulders. All right, Ray Graham is going to get out to the right there and get this to be second and three. So we're going to call his number again. Of course, nice blocking. First down. So he's accumulating yardage after that big 100-yard rush. Sinceri throwing to Carswell. He's going to drag people just far enough for first down. First and 10, not quite first and goal. Ray Graham up the middle. Very close to getting in. Third and 8 now, though. And they're passing to the right. Holtz says, oh, no, you don't. Shoves him to the turf and gets in the end zone. Watch this stiff arm, folks. This is a play and a half. Watch this. Boom, sit down. Oh, man. That's a pretty strong dude right there. I'll have to be remembering that in future games. So 21-3 right now in the third quarter. Ray Graham show again. Can he burst it all the way? Nope, not quite. But oh, he's dangerous. He almost got out there in space again. Third and four. Sinceri to pass. Over the middle of the Carswell again. Oh, look at him spin. He's not going to go down easily. First and goal. Pittsburgh. The Panthers punch it in. Ray Graham will not be denied. Look at him turning those legs. Moving that upper body. Punishing people on the way into the end zone. For a small guy, he can pack a punch. And there you go. Ray Graham in the end zone himself once again. Things starting to look better offensively, you know, despite the four turnovers. My goodness. So 28-3. Going deep. Loading up. Oh, Sadler is going to make that catch for the touchdown. Now they show off the long ball threat. They do have it apparently in the arsenal. Sinceri gets this ball downfield. A little bit of a wobbler, but that's okay because he's wide open. And he gets in the end zone for another Pitt Panther touchdown. What do we have? We got a little bit of an injury concern. Ooh, that's a big injury concern. Ray Graham, but he's just dinged up a little bit. We're going to sub him out because this game is already out of hand. Also, we sub in, well, pretty much all the backups. You see backup quarterback in the ball game. That's Myers. Hey, cool name. Myers, close enough. And he's going to get Carswell, who's going to be really close to a touchdown. Drew Carswell, 72 yards on four catches. Oh, so close to the end zone. Hand off to that backup running back, Brown, and he is in for the touchdown, dreadlocks and all. We've got a studio update in that game we saw before. Yeah, Northwestern pulls away and beats Syracuse. Tough day for Syracuse. Not good for them. Pittsburgh looking pretty good, though. The lefty, Myers, going to air it out. Who cares if it's running up? He hits Holtz. Minus 100 sportsmanship? Yeah, put it on Minnesota's bill. That's my team in that little deal. Like, I care. Okay, so this pass is over the middle for yet another touchdown. Look at the lefty deliver. Steve Young, anybody? Yeah, maybe we're drawing too lofty a comparison, but yet the lefty connects there on the play for the touchdown. The game ends mercifully in a 49-3 win over FCS Midwest. Yes, sir, they had some fun when they finally figured out the turnover thing. Stop turning over the ball and you'll have a good day. Ray Graham, your player of the game, and why not? 218 yards and two touchdowns. Very good day for him, and he survived a little ding there in the game and is fine here. So looking around the league, you see a little bit of the storylines going on. You can see some of the teams and the people controlling them as we get some stories coming in. Ooh, South Florida, tough loss to Florida. You got Toledo upsetting LSU. Come on, man. Rocket ships. Coleman will love that. My boy Coleman is a fan of the rocket ships, as you'll see later on in another dynasty. Anyway, whoo, boy. Okay, we just about made it through week one. I'll just take a sweep through of all the players here. You see ASU wins. Northern Illinois on the board. NC State, yes. Cal, oh, Caveman Swag had a tough one. Breezy Flash, yep, he couldn't quite get it done. Virginia gets it in. Ole Miss will take the game. You got K-State winning. Misfit 1413, that is my buddy Jim, Junk Gaming Videos. He will have videos of his games in the league as well for UCLA. Check it out. Ray Graham atop the leaders, the NCAA rushing leader after 1 week. That's not saying much, it's 1 week. But Sinceri is 16th on the passing leader list. As we see some other users get their guys up there as well. Toledo's quarterback number one. Looking at a little recruiting again, we found a gem at center. Okay, you think we can beat out some others at it? Well, we're number one on the list for him so far. Hopefully we can offer this dude a scholarship. Alfred Horton, you're coming to Pitt, baby. You know you want to. Okay, well, we actually got an athlete, a four-star caliber athlete, which you can put at several positions. We'll look at our positions in need and fill him accordingly. But yeah, four-star in the fold, all right. He wanted Pitt. He was on the top of his list, and he accepted the scholarship when we offered it right away. So there you go. That's the first week in the Dynasty. Pretty good. We've advanced to week two. I think most people have played their week two game as well. We'll get to that as soon as we can. And for me, it's a matchup with Insane Predator. Yes, it's a user game already in week two for me. Predator and I have some history. We played some great games online, whether it be in Dynasties or just some little online ranked action. It's always a good time. So come back for that as I take on his Cincinnati Bearcats. Other good games in the leagues as well. We'll see you next time in the Xbox Dynasty. See ya.